यहाँ ढंग से पानी नहीं आता और लैटरिन तो इतनी गंदी होती है कि मजबूरी में हम लोगों को जाना पड़ता है।
यहाँ पर पानी की बहुत बड़ी समस्या है। पानी यहाँ गर्मियों में 1.5 महीने में 15 दिन में 1 महीने में आता है, और जिसमें कि पानी में कीड़े भी पड़ जाते हैं, और वही पानी अब लोग बागों को पीना भी पड़ता है, हम लोगों को ही पीना पड़ता है।
गरीब बच्चे पढ़ाई लिखाई से वंचित हो गए और इनका एडमिशन तक नहीं हो पा रहा। महिलाओं को परेशानी है, लैट्रिन बाथरूम नहाने धोने की परेशानी है। अगर कोई लेडीज रात बिरात अगर बीमार हो जाए तो कोई सुविधा नहीं है। पहले दवाइयाँ छिड़की जाती थी, अब वो भी सुविधा नहीं है। गर्मी के दौरान इतने मच्छर पैदा होते हैं कि इतने बच्चे इस साल बीमार पड़े, कोई दवाइयों की सुविधा नहीं है।
We have seen how if the government wants to work for the elite and the rich, they would do it. But the same commitment that it has for the rich and the, you know, well-off, even 1% if it had for the poor urban workers and the city makers, I think our city would have been a better place to live in. But unfortunately, I think it's very clear that the government doesn't work for the poor or the city makers. It works for the city destroyers or city leeches who actually make city and who rob the city, you know, and who deprive the poor of their rights, all these elite people, you know.
Indian society is a caste-based society. In this, is Dalits facing the various kinds of discrimination and the untouchability practices. If you look at the nature of the kinds of untouchability practices, it's a denying access to various resources. It's a kind of a power relation. If anybody attempts to access those resources, there are the violence. This violence is increasing day by day. This is irrespective of the religion and the caste. And if you look at the data, the study done by the various organizations, the untouchability practices, there are the new forms of discrimination are emerging due to the policy and the program interventions of the government also.
Sarkari mein marte pirte hain, Aidarpur hospital mein marte pirte hain, Jagjivan Ram hospital mein marte pirte hain, driver patient ko. Aisa hi hota hai, paise to ilaj hota hai, nahi to khatam ho jata hai. क्या होता है जो जिस गरीबों के पास पैसे नहीं रहेगा तो उसका क्या इलाज होगा।
आज हम बिल्कुल नरक का जीवन जी रहे हैं, कोई हमारा ठिकाना नहीं, कोई बस्ती के अंदर भलाई नेहरू कैंप सी ब्लॉक हो, संजय कैंप बी ब्लॉक हो, निर्माण कैंप ए ब्लॉक हो, यह बहुजन समाज है, ये लोहिया कैंप या अम्बेडकर कैंप, किसी कैंप में हमारा जीवन का ठिकाना नहीं है।
वो हम सब बिल्कुल एकदम कवार में रहते हैं, बिल्कुल कोई आज तलक देखने भी नहीं आते। शीला दीसी को जिस टाइम वो बनी है, बिल्कुल आम जनते बैठे ऐसे बैठा कर उसको चाय पिलाए, जो आम जनता चाय पीते हैं वो पी कर गई, बोला कि तुम्हारे सबको यहाँ एकदम बिल्कुल पक्की बना देंगे। आज तलक देखने भी नहीं आई हमारे सबको कि किस तरह रहते हैं जुगियों वालों। 6 महीने में कबार निकालते, वो कबार कोई फेंकने वाला नहीं होता, हम सब अपना हाथों से फेंकते हैं। हमारे भाई सब जितने लड़के सब है वो सब उठा उठा कर फेंकते हैं, कभी आज तक फेंकने भी नहीं आता, कहता हम नहीं फेंकेंगे, जाओ अपने रहने दो। हम चीनी चावल कुछ नहीं मिलते, खाली सिर्फ 20 किलो गेहूं मिलते हैं, 2 रुपए किलो के गेहूं देता वो मिलते ना, तो कभी विधवा वाले को पैसे दिए ना, तो कोई विधवा वालों को कोई देखने भी आए, मौसमाती पैसा नहीं दिया, छठ वर्षा पैसा नहीं दिया, और सबसे लिख लिख कर ले गया, पैसे भी ले गया, वो कहाँ गया, और कोई आज तक देखने भी नहीं आए। आज से नहीं, हमारे सब 84 से यहाँ पर रहते हैं, कोई सुनवाई नहीं होते। अब बताओ हमारे सब किसको जाए कहने के लिए, कौन देखते हैं हमारे सबको।
As per the 2008, that's the end of mass, you know, 10th 5-year plan. It's the government figures that there's a shortage of 24.7 million houses, which is 2.5 crore houses for the urban areas, and 99% shortage is for economically weaker sections and LIG sections. So who are the EWS and LIG sections? Obviously most of the Dalits. So all these years you have allowed the shortages to be there. DDA, Delhi Development Authority, which has been entrusted the responsibility of creating houses, has only created houses for the MIG and HIGs. So elite would never complain because they have been taken care of very, very nicely. You know, it's only when it comes to the city makers, to the urban workers, you find the deficit. So if slums are mushrooming in Delhi, if there are a large number of people, about 60 to 70% of people in Delhi are living in slums, similarly these cases in Bombay and other places, then how can you blame them? How can you blame the urban workers who are living in slums?
बच्चों के लिए कमाने खाने आए हैं। डीडीओ ने हमसे क्या बोले? जब यहाँ हम आए, यहाँ सरकारी जगह है, यहाँ बनाते हैं, सारी पब्लिक बना लिए, 10,000 दो, 20,000 दो, 10,000 एक दीवाल का, 20,000 दो दीवाल का, 30,000 तीन दीवाल का, 40,000 चार दीवाल का, 20,000 कल के डेट में मैंने दिए उस सीताराम को और बैद्यनाथ को, यहाँ से पब्लिक के पैसे ले जाके अपना जेब भर रहे हैं, हम पब्लिक को भूखा मार रहे हैं, हम कोठियों में काम कर रहे हैं, अपने बच्चे नहीं पाल पा रहे हैं, आप पैसे दे देंगे अपना घर बना रहे हैं, अभी कल भी नहीं मना करे की चुग्गी नहीं टूटेगी,
हमारा घर टूट गया
और कल भी मना करके गए की चुग्गी नहीं टूटेगी और आज कल की डेट में चुग्गी टूट गई, उन्होंने ये मना करके गए की चुग्गी नहीं टूटेगी।
Last 2 hours, I am listening to you. Okay, now let him execute his duty. This is a duty now.
You have to allow us to speak to the commissioner, sir.
Please go and speak.
Yeah. This morning, you all are coming.
This is a disputed one.
आज होता है वो दिल्ली के उच्च न्यायालय के आदेश का उल्लंघन होगा, तो इसलिए हमें हिम्मत का हाथ बांधना है।
I think it's a very, very sad story. In this country, you have now had progressive laws and legislation for decades. However, I would say both the Dalits as well as the Adivasis have not been able to have access to either social infrastructure or physical infrastructure. So government schemes and money is made and spent on their name, but actually Dalits do not have access to those resources. So it's really a very, very sad story.
You look at it from all aspects, the whole aspect of governance, of monitoring, the aspect of disbursement of funds, the aspect of you know, showing that there is concern and care for the cities most marginalized. There's been a tremendous failure at the level of governance, and this status quo of neglect and discrimination continues to this day in spite of these revelations. In fact, the funds have not yet been put back, and even if they are, there doesn't seem to be a plan for how they will be utilized. So from all aspects, this is a very, very serious situation that needs national attention. It needs international attention. It's actually a slap in the face of the Dalits first and foremost in Delhi, but also a slap in the face of the secular nature of the country, of the, you know, the very progressive measures suggested in the Indian Constitution.
Since you have 24 lakh Dalit population in Delhi, it's not a small number, and the government of Delhi says we are unable to implement this because we do not know where the Dalits are. Census very clearly says, and you see them everywhere, it is that you like caste discrimination, you want to be, you want to totally reject and deny that this kind of a community exists, and this kind of a community has this clear entitlement which needs to be fulfilled. That obligation of the state to fulfill the protection and promotion of their rights, especially the economic and civic rights, I think this is something that we need to take up.
Has to be en masse housing for the poor, en masse housing which includes water, sanitation, you know, and other services as such for the urban workers, for the Dalits. If the government of Delhi and government of India is serious and sincere of using the, you know, SC subplan component in terms of using it for Dalits, for the scheduled castes and as such, I think there are hundreds of areas where it can do in Delhi. The only thing is, it hasn't got the political will.
Children have any future because they don't have any access to higher education. There is discrimination. You don't have any act to address the discrimination. There is discrimination in the private sector. You don't have any act to see that the discrimination is being addressed. On top of that, the money that is supposed to be for our development, you are not willing to take. You are not willing to have schemes. You are not willing to build proper colleges for us, proper nursing colleges for us, proper medical colleges for us. We demand development, nothing else.